Hey, Dr. C here with you. Here are the top seven questions I've been getting about thyroid antibodies. And this is important stuff. People find that they have them present, you know, they have symptoms, and now more doctors are testing for thyroid antibodies. Not all are, but more are. And people that are adults in the modern world and are symptomatic in some way, probably a quarter or more of them have positive thyroid antibodies. So countless people are now told, you have these thyroid antibodies, you've got this autoimmune reaction, but they don't really know what to do about that. So here's some big questions and some simple answers. So for starters, what are they? Well, there's a couple of structures in the thyroid that are part of making hormone. First off is thyroglobulin. That's a template. And then you have thyroid peroxidase. That's an oxidizer. So iodine getting stuck on the template is how thyroid hormones are made. Thyroglobulin is a template, and thyroid peroxidase activates iodide and converts it to iodine. So dide and dine. I'm exaggerating those. But once it becomes iodine, it finds its way and it sticks onto various spots on thyroglobulin. Well, because iodine is so volatile, it upsets the immune system. And the immune system ends up attacking the areas in which it's found. And those include thyroglobulin and thyroid peroxidase. So quite simply, these are antibodies against the template and against the activating enzyme. So next question I get is, do thyroid antibodies affect your health apart from your thyroid? And the answer on that is they can. So there's three big things we know they can do. They can cause certain symptoms like fatigue or facial swelling or hair loss. They can also affect fertility, and they may raise the risk for heart disease. Now, I want to make a real clear distinction. Thyroid, abnormal thyroid function can do all that stuff and then some. There's almost no limit to the ways that abnormal thyroid levels can cause health problems. And so in a lot of cases, the things that we would blame on thyroid antibodies are probably more directly related to changes in thyroid function than they are to the antibodies, because people with abnormal thyroid antibodies often develop abnormal thyroid function. But in those who have the antibodies present, but their thyroid levels are stable, either their thyroid never slowed down or they're on appropriate amounts of medication, those people still have greater risks in those ways. So it can be relevant to think about improving your thyroid antibodies, even if your thyroid levels already are healthy. It can affect your health in other ways. Another question I hear quite a bit is whether thyroid antibodies mean that you have thyroid disease. And this is a curious one. My views on this have evolved as our science has evolved and changed. So not everyone that has measurable thyroid antibodies necessarily has thyroid disease. In fact, many don't ever develop thyroid disease. What's changed about this is that we've known forever that cells have to get rid of old cells. You know, these thyroid cells are all huddled up in a circle and they all talk amongst themselves and they say, huh, you know, Joe hasn't been really pulling his weight lately. Joe should probably go to the retirement home. And in this case, Joe's like, yep, you guys are right. I'm out of here. See you later. So we call that apoptosis. That's coordinated cellular death. We get rid of old cells when they need to, cells decide when old cells should go. Now what we've learned is that part of that is done by the immune system. So antibodies to thyroid proteins are part of what comes in and gets rid of those cells. So there's normal ways by which this mechanism occurs in healthy people. So then we think about how much these antibodies change the risk for thyroid disease progressing. And this is something that's the next big question. It turns out that high antibodies do make someone more likely to have their thyroid shut off than low levels of antibodies are. That's kind of a no-brainer, right? But the numbers have surprised me. So one group of people that has only one antibody and it's below 100, say they've only got positive thyroid peroxidase, their thyroglobulin is negative, and thyroid peroxidase is like 50 units per mil. It's very low. And now we're going to compare them against another group to where both antithyroglobulin, antithyroid peroxidase are well over 500 IUs per mil. So yeah, one barely positive, two really positive. Well, the first group, their 9-year risk of developing overt thyroid disease is about 15%. So 15% over 9 years, that's a little less than 2% a year. So in other words, those who have a low elevation of thyroid peroxidase have about a 2% annual risk of developing thyroid disease, or 98% chance of not having any problems, nothing going wrong. On the other hand, if both antibodies are very elevated, that risk goes to about 31% over a 9-year period, or just over 3% per year. So neither of those was catastrophically high, right? And well, what, 15 versus 31, so it was twice as high. But when you annualize that, you know, less than 2%, slightly over 3% risk, these don't mean you're destined to fail. That's a big message I'd love for you to hear. You can have positive thyroid antibodies and have positively no effects from them. They might not do anything. So it doesn't mean that you're destined to have your thyroid shut down. And here's a corresponding question. If my antibodies become negative, does that mean my thyroid disease has reversed? And I've seen a lot of folks put a lot of energy into this being like the holy grail of thyroid health. You know, I had these positive antibodies, but I did all these extreme things. Now I've cured myself of thyroid disease. Well, antibodies can come and go. They're not always the same result. And again, we saw how even if they're positive, they're not perfectly predictive of developing thyroid disease. And a lot of folks who get thyroid disease never have positive antibodies. So them going negative is totally fine. But if you did that at the expense of your health, that wasn't a win. You know, things like steroids, like a shot of Kenalog or an oral course of prednisone, or antihistamines, you know, these things can make your antibodies go negative in no time, but you're not healthier for it. So I do want to decouple the idea that any way your thyroid antibodies go negative means that now you're healthier, now you're in better shape. Not everyone with thyroid disease has positive antibodies, and not everyone with positive antibodies develops thyroid disease. Next big question, how should you test your thyroid antibodies? Well, thyroid tests, if they're done in an inconsistent way, the results can fluctuate a lot in ways that are not meaningful. So thyroid tests you always want to do before taking thyroid medication, before food, in the morning between about 6 to 9 a.m., 3 or more days after taking any supplements. Now, a big one here with antibodies is probiotics. This can surprise people, but probiotics can cause false changes in anti-thyroid peroxidase antibodies. And last up is your menstrual cycle. You want to test first week, last week, not mid-cycle. So yeah, days 10 through 20, avoid testing. Now, if you're a guy or if you're a menopausal woman or you've had hysterectomy, you don't worry about it because you can't. So yeah, no worries that way. But time your tests in ways that are meaningful. And probably the biggest thing about testing I'd love to impart is just to know that thyroid antibodies are squirrely. They bounce around. You can't put a lot of weight in one reading to the next. You only know their trend when you look at many, many, many readings over a longer period of time. A very high or a very low one can totally be a fluke and can mean nothing whatsoever. Last up is, can diet lower thyroid antibodies? And easy answer is yes. There's been studies on this in terms of low iodine diets, AIP diets, gluten-free diets, dairy-free diets, also vegan diets, and they've all been looked at pretty thoroughly. The most data we have is about low iodine diets. And not only can they lower the antibodies, but they can reverse the whole disease. And remember, the antibodies form as an attack against iodine on thyroglobulin and iodine affecting thyroid peroxidase. So that's why they're there and that's why they're high. So the more you can really control the iodine intake, the better you can reverse that whole process. All right, Dr. C with you. Take great care and I'll see you again real soon. Bye-bye.